morning, guys. We're actually here at Foster Rocks today. We at the estuary. We came to pump some crackers to get some bait. The weather's looking nice. It's very nice. But overcast. We had some passing showers, but we're definitely going to get fish today. Quite excited for that. So if the guys are wondering actually where Foster Rock is, Foster Rock's at the Wild Coast Casino. So you come down to the main beach, and it's actually about 2.5 km down to the left. Actually to the right. So yeah, let's get some cracker and get some bait and we go in. Morning, guys. We down here at Wild Coast Sun Casino. It's on the extreme right of me. It's about a 3K walk to where we're at the moment. This place is called the Fossil Rock. It's directly opposite the Fossil Forest. It's a very scenic area. Lovely place. Beautiful walk down here, beautiful scenery. I really like this place. I haven't fished here for a while, but we're going to be targeting edibles today, early this morning. And then during the course of the day, we're actually going to go for the non-eds. So today, we're mostly going to be targeting the rockfish. So it's going to be your bronze bream, your stone bream, your mussel cracker, as well as your rock art. Your rock art is actually going to be our bonus fish for today. Water's looking quite nice. The weather's not too promising. It's cloudy, a bit of rain, but we're going to continue fishing and we're going to hope to get something. So I'll see you guys soon as we get something. How's it, guys? Alright, I'm going to be showing you guys the bait that I'm going to be using to target the rockfish this morning. I'm using a number 2 mussel bait holder. I find this hook very strong, extremely sharp. It's one of my favorite mussel hooks that I actually use when I'm fishing for rockfish. This is actually the product here. It's an excellent hook, something that you should keep in your bait box. And I'm basically going to be tying a prawn and cracker bait. I'll show you guys how I actually do it. First thing I do is I actually cut the prawn in the center in half, and then I turn him inside out onto the hook. Quite simple. Keeping the hook proud. And then I just cotton that up. I try to put as little cotton as possible towards the hook, but more on the back. I want the bait nice and soft in the front. Not too much, not too tight as well. Sneaking it up a bit. Okay, that's perfect as it is. Now I'm going to apply the cracker onto the prawn bait. Just remember, when fishing with cracker, you do need a bait collecting license for this. It's 50 per person as well. So limit your catch, don't catch your limit. And all the crackers that you're not actually using, if you're returning back to, if you're fishing in the same area where you pump them from, just throw them back in the holes, and you know, it'd be better for the next guy that actually comes to pump crackers, because these are actually a mission to get as well. So I just put the cracker on the prawn like this, and just tie him up. I leave his arms dangling. It's more action in the water, so I don't actually tie that up. I just tie the body. And like I said, not a lot of cotton, just a little. Your bait up. That's basically the bait that I would use for targeting rockfish. It's a nice juicy bait as well. So let's put this in the water and let's see if we can get something. Just one introduction about my tackle setup that I'm actually using here today. It's the Saltus Power Spin 11'6". It's my favorite splashing rod, and I pair that up with my Saltiga 4'5". It's an excellent setup. I've got 20-pound J braid in this as well. This braid is absolutely phenomenal. It has a lot of abrasion on it. So fishing in the rocks like this here, it's a breeze. I've got full confidence in the braid, and I can hook almost anything in it with it. My trace is, like I said, it's a basic snatching trace. So I've got a piece of bead here in the front, so I don't get cut off. And I must have bait holder as well. I'm using a number 3 bottle sinker. It doesn't look like it's a bit of a tip. I'm just going to use the number 3 for now. Obviously, I'll go a bit lighter as I'm fishing. Just want to see what the water's like now. So let's, enough talking, let's get a bait in and get some fish. How's it guys? My name is Chairman Adias and I'm actually fishing with the 9-foot Daiwa Mega Force with my Daiwa Laguna 4000, and I'm using 50-pound J-braid. And as you can see, I've got a lantern fish here on prawn and cracker. Lovely small little couple here we got. Mustard baitola, got him in the corner. Perfect. Actually threw the bait right in this thing's mouth. 11.6 power spin. And the Saltiga did the job. 20-pound J-braid. Let's get this guy back and get another one. We have a quarantine here. Alright guys, target species, bronze bream, a bit small, but we'll take it. I actually got that on the prawn and cracker bait. As you can see, the bait all got in properly. So let's get this bad boy back and get another one. 11.6 power spin, Saltiga, 4.5. Alright guys, a bit of a slow morning. We managed to get a few fish. The tide's actually pushing quite a lot now, so we can't fish on the rocks that we were fishing previously. So what we're going to do is we're going to go back to the beach. We're going to fish for some edibles there and also try for some non-eds. So I'll see you guys soon.